Hey guys, happy Thursday from Mrs. Ritter. Today is day 19 of your AMI packet, or April 16th, and this is your activity for 8th and 9th grade English. The first thing that you're going to do is read a book or text of your choice for 30 minutes. You can read independently, or you can choose to read to someone in your house, like a parent or sibling. You're going to note the title, author, and the number of pages read, and then choose one way to write about your reading from the menu of options. Just as a reminder, that menu of options is on page 15 at the bottom of this packet. Another option you have is you can reread a text or a part of a text that you've already read and choose a different response option from that menu on page 15. After that, you're going to read your narrative from yesterday out loud to yourself and be on careful lookout for phrases and sentences that don't sound natural, and try to correct any grammatical or spelling mistakes to create a second draft of the current life narrative. So a couple reminders here. Reading your paper out loud to yourself might feel a little funny at first, but it's a really great skill for English and for any other class where you're writing because it helps you pick up on things that don't sound quite like how we would talk in real life. And it's things you might miss if you just quickly read over it in your head. So do be sure to read your paper out loud, even if it's just to yourself. Another thing that you might find very helpful is to make your changes and your corrections in a separate color or highlight them. That way your teacher and you can see the corrections that you've made and the improvements that you've made on your writing. And it shows your teacher that you're dealing with writing as a process, which it truly is a process. It's not just a one and done kind of thing. It's something that we do and then we perfect and we change and we keep doing that until it's how we want it. So your day 19 goals overall is to read your current life narrative out loud. And then I think we've got a little typo here. We're just focused on the current life narrative today. So you're going to read it out loud. You're going to proofread your current life narrative. Hopefully you've already proofread your middle life narrative. And you're going to correct anything you want to change. And last but not least, you're going to make all three parts of your interview project narrative read as clean and smooth as you possibly can. So you might need to add transitions in your paragraphs, between your paragraphs, anything to just make it flow and sound like a story. You're writing about three different parts of a person's life, but you want it to sound like you're telling their life story overall. As usual, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to your English teachers. We love helping you guys. We love hearing from you guys. And we truly miss you and hope all is well.